Little known fact, when I moved to Minnesota all those years ago, I was living in Uptown and I didn't have any friends. So I went to the movies a lot. The Uptown Theater, to be specific. And every time I went there, I went for two reasons. One, obviously, see the movie. But just as important to me was seeing what those brilliant minds would put up on the Uptown Theater Marquee.
It's right in the heart of Uptown, and I would argue it is the heart of Uptown.
It's just kind of another aspect of the Uptown Theater experience that you're not going to get at unnamed other theaters.
Seriously, every week you will pass by this marquee and do one of two things. Laugh your face off because the joke they make is that clever, or furrow your brow off because it's so clever it makes absolutely no sense to you. Let's throw out some examples, like this one, for last month's Nocturnal Animals.
Bring all your friends here, it'll be a hoot.
That was a good one. I wish I could take credit for that.
Or one of my favorites, last week's La La Land billing, classic Gosling dig. How about mocking Shia LaBeouf when American Honey came out? Genius. And how about the pun with Joaquin Phoenix, getting you to walk in to see his last movie? Yes. Funny every time. You are a national treasure, Uptown Theater Marquee.
So who comes up with
it? We all do. That's kind of the nice thing about this theater is it's not like a bunch of people who just needed a job and they're like, oh, we're going to movie theater. It's people who want to work here and they're artists and musicians and filmmakers.
Yes, the lot of them come up with the lot of them. But he did relay one little secret if you think this week's marquee is subpar.
Sometimes it's too cold, so we'll just do something super basic.
It's too cold to put up a clever marquee.
Like, you don't want to put up something like super long.
All right, that's fair. But think about the length he just mentioned. These guys and gals have basically been jamming out before that was a thing.
Less than a tweet. I know that.
It's less than 140 characters?
I think so, yeah.
Whoa.
I know. So you gotta get even more succinct and clever.
So you guys were clever before clever was cool.
Yeah. We were kind of the beginning of cool clever.
Every week they have to make a pun, a wordplay, in less than 140 characters. And so let's just give you one more, because this is a personal favorite of Rich's, one that really stands out just this last fall.
It was for that movie, The Hollers, and it was, I'm gonna start laughing when I say it, Anna Kendrick Ain't No Hollers Back Girl.
It was so good, Anna Kendrick herself had to chime in with approval.
As much as I want to be mad about this, I can't be.
And with that, I say take a bow. Uptown Theater, Marquee.
That's awesome.
That's after Rich. He's like, you picked the absolutely worst day to do this interview because the marquee is so bad, it just says Jackie.
But where'd you get all the pictures from? Are they on social media?
On social media. Yeah. I mean, you can find them all over the place. You see people take pictures of the marquee because it's hilarious so many times. And then they'll put it on their Twitter page. So follow the Uptown Theater on Twitter and you'll see a lot of these. But I remember that Anna Kendrick one. You're at the stoplight in that like terrible part of Uptown and you just laugh, shake your head. Yeah. You're like, you cute Minneapolis. That's
I think
funny.
It's awesome. It's old school fun. It's great. It's witty.
Yeah, every other theater, right? They just say movie,
the title,
rating, that's it.
You know that place is going to be a good place to go to or it's going to be fun. They
it's
have character.
Yep, yep.